Hello, it's nice to see you. I'm glad you could make it. We are officially upon the absolute best reading of the year. There's something about fall reading time that just hits the spot. And if you've been around my channel recently at all, you would know that I am in fact taking fall reading a little too far, okay? The delusional TBR that I have set for myself, the amount of books that I have acquired to be read this fall, completely out of hand. And if you were wondering, it's stressing me out. Yeah, crazy, I know. I did it all to myself. I know I did it to myself, but whatever's going on in here, Stress. I want to read everything that I have on my mind, which is a little bit of 100 books. Not really attainable, not really feasible, right? So I thought it'd be fun for both of us to let you blindly choose my TBR. So I posted stories on my Instagram, two books pinned against each other. These are the two books. These are all pinned against each other, but you couldn't see what book was underneath them. I chose the color that covered the cover from the cover, so that was a hint. And then I tried, really, really intense emphasis on try when it comes to this round, to correlate emojis to what was gonna like maybe go on inside a little bit. Some of them for sure got guessed. A lot of them I knew in the moment were bad. However, there are sometimes not emojis to explain. Period. The stories have been up for the full 24 hours now. We have winners in every single category. I don't know why I said that like a game show. It's not categories. The books don't even necessarily always correlate to like the same genre. And I guess if you want to participate next time, make sure you're following me on Instagram, because that is where this type of voting will always take place. And without further ado, a big thank you to you for taking my TBR out of my hands. For our very first two books pinned against each other, these were both actually in the fantasy genre. At this point, they correlated. I tried to pick books at least in the same genre. But on the left, we have a really dark navy blue cover, and then a Roman Colosseum and a sparkle. And I know, you're saying, literally, what is that? I get it. You know what? Actually, some of you did get it. I sat here for like 5 minutes being like, based on what this story is about and looking at the cover, this is all I have. This is literally all I can give. And if you guessed The Will of the Many by James Islington, you're a wizard. You're actually a wizard, because I never, ever would have gotten it. There's like a Roman Colosseum-esque thing on the cover, but I'm pretty sure it has something to do with like an orphaned child and some sort of revolution. I know it's extremely political, and I'm pretty sure it's fantasy. It's fantasy, right? Is it not? I mean, it is fantasy. I know it's fantasy. Now I'm questioning everything. I see magic on the back. I was right. It's fantasy. If you got this, you're actually a wizard, because I never would have gotten it. But I don't know how I could have done it better. But on the right, we have a dark red cover with a drop of blood, the Colosseum, and a vampire. And so many people guessed this, and I'm sure you can guess what it is sitting here in this pile. And it is, in fact, Immortal Dark. This is so high on my mental TBR. Like, I want to read this ASAP. I've seen so many people loving it. This is probably like the release for fall I was probably most excited for. After seeing the author's videos on TikToks, like in anticipation of this coming out. I don't know a lot about it other than it's dark academia, vampire, dark vibes. But I've heard it's amazing. And after your guys' votes, The Will of the Many got 35% and Immortal Dark got 65%, which means this is the very first book on our October TBR, and a very happy Maddie, because I wanted to read this. This will be our little TBR pile. We can watch it grow. Moving on, the book on the left is a really dark blue. I literally actually selected the colors from the covers to make the color to cover over the covers. Brain rot. That was actually brain rot, because I hoped that was at least a little hint if the emojis didn't help at all. And a lot of you guessed this one as well. On the left, we have a sparkle, which to me, I just use a sparkle as it's fantasy. It's magic, baby. A skull and a very old witch that I didn't realize until after the fact. Might have been confusing, but it's what came up when I typed in witch. And these books are actually two series that I'm in the middle of. That's the only reason that they were connected in my brain. And this is a Kingdom of the Cursed. I almost said The Wicked. I did read the first book. I'm like 30-40 pages into this one on my Kindle, and I pick it up like whenever I have time, but I have the physical book now, so I can actually read it like dedicatedly. And then on the right, we have a baby blue-ish color, ballerina slippers, a black heart, and a knife. And actually, a lot of you got this, which I was surprised by, because I don't think I ever would have gotten this, but if you've read it, I guess I'm just gonna tell you. Stolen Air by Sophie Lark. This is the second book in the Brutal Prince series that she did. I got the Kingmaker series, like randomly walked into a bookstore, saw it, and was sold by it. And a lot of people said that I had to read, not had to, but I should read the Brutal Prince series first, because it's their kids, like it's the second generation. So I read the Brutal Prince in a 24-hour reading video that you guys are gonna get very soon. And I liked it so much. Like, I went in anticipating it'd be like meh. I really liked it. I actually really liked it. And with 39%, we have Kingdom of the Cursed, which means we are adding Stolen Heir by Sophie Lark with 61% to the TBR. The next genre of books was a reread. I've been doing a lot of rereading through audiobooks recently. There's something comforting about knowing where a story is gonna go. I will say I did listen to Magnolia Parks, which it is now the fourth time that I've consumed the first Magnolia Parks book. And I was walking chance listening to it, crying down the streets of Toronto. We don't have to talk about that. Inadvertently, unnoticingly, subconsciously mouthing the words, two quotes in a book. When is it out of hand? When is the obsession out of hand? On the left, we have like a beigey color. It was supposed to be gold, but I mean, you can't really, gold's not a flat color. And we have a crow, a white heart, the little magic sparkles, and a sword. And this was for Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. I just finished re-listening to Six of Crows, and I actually listened to this the first time that I quote unquote read it. So I've never actually physically read this, and this is a 6-star read for me, like tore my heart out. Re-listening to Six of Crows, knowing what happens in this, brought tears to my eyes on more than one occasion. I just love the fam family. Like, this is the tier of fam family, this series for me. First book is basically a heist story, and I've seen so much discourse about it online. I just have no words for it other than I love it. If you read like me and you love a plot line, you will love Six of Crows. And then this one is astronomically better, but I never read it, so I never annotated it. And then on the right, we have a really dark navy blue, a daisy, and a set of kitchen utensils, which, yes, yeah, all of you got. And it is in fact Daisy Hates by Jessa Hastings, the second book in the Magnolia Park series, because obviously, I mean, I don't have to explain, really, I don't. Look at the annotations in here. Can you even tell? It's quite egregious. Daisy Hates got 39%, and Crooked Kingdom, which will be added to the TBR, got 61%. Isn't that exactly what the last one got too? Whoa, that's so weird. My God, I was only off by like 10 votes. Almost exactly the same. Weird, y'all are in tune, clearly. Adding Crooked Kingdom to the TBR. These two are stored on my bookshelf together, but they're not the same genre. But for some reason, they feel like they should be stored together for me. Maybe once I've read them, I won't feel that. I mean, I know I won't, because they're not the same genre. However, I want to read both of these, kind of equally. On the left, we have a dark greenish-esque cover, a sparkle, a heart, a fir tree, and a girl. This is probably the one that I'm the least proud of. Like, I don't know how anyone could have gotten this. I don't even totally understand the plot of this, but knowing what I know about the plot, there was absolutely nothing that I felt that I could attribute to it. And it was The Unmaking of June Farrow by Adrienne Young. Yeah, no, I get it. The emojis, they don't really correlate. From what I've gathered, it's about June Farrow, whose family, all the women have been cursed, and she's trying to unbreak the curse. I did trees because there's trees on the covers, and then it's magical, so I did that. I don't know. I'm not proud of it either, okay? And then on the right, we have like kind of a dusty baby pink, a campsite, a space. You can't really tell there's a space, but I really tried to do the space. And then a drip and a pink heart. Now that I've explained it, you kind of know where I'm going. I felt like it was kind of clever. The God of the Woods by Liz Moore. You get it? Because of the pink drip. Yeah, I see. I get it. I don't know how I would have guessed either of them either. However, I couldn't think of anything better in the moment. This is a thriller, so like not in the same genre as The Unmaking of June Farrow. However, I bought them at the same time, and the covers feel similar to me. This takes place in, I think, the 1970s, something like that, in the Adirondacks, and it is about a camp where everyone wakes up one morning and someone is missing, and it's all about, like, unraveling family secrets, which literally sold. I feel the same about this and The Unmaking of June Farrow that I felt about Half a Soul, that it's like, I don't know a lot about it, I don't know why I think I love it, but I think I will. Like, I have a really good feeling, which is the best, because I tend to be right. Like, when a woman listens to her intuition, things go well. The God of the Woods got 47%, which means The Unmaking of June Farrow is added to the TBR with 53%. I feel like this was a shot in the dark. Like, I know, mostly no one knew what they were voting for, but that's okay. We have two fantasies again, pinned against each other. On the left, we have like a dark maroony, I almost said navy. Navy is blue. Maroon, auburny color. We have a sparkle, a fairy, and scissors. And if you've been around my channel, you know what series this is from. I feel like you really do. And this is for Long Shadow by Olivia Atwater. This is the third and final book in the Regency Fairy Tale series that started with Half a Soul. And no, I don't have a single idea what this one in particular is about, because I've gone in blind to the other two and it was the best decision I've ever made. However, I thought if you knew me, you'd know how much I loved Half a Soul, and you would know it's about fairies and iron scissors. That was the thought process. The author's display picture on social media is a pair of scissors. That was the mentality, okay? And then on the right, we have a hot pink cover, sparkles, a sword, and a veil. I know you don't know what this is. Okay, I get it. It's not that great. Lady Macbeth by Ava Reid. This is the same author that wrote A Study in Drowning that everyone loved last year and I have not read yet. However, this is an an example of a book that I just went to the bookstore, saw it, it sold me, which does not happen very often. It's giving book buying problem occurring in the moment. And I know that this is about a woman who's married to a brute, is how they explain him. And while she studies magic, she thinks that he might also be under some sort of magical influence, and it's gonna take all of her power to keep herself alive. I don't know a lot, however, the synopsis did sell me. This cover is beautiful, and also on the inside, it is a beautiful hot pink naked hardback. I'm obsessed, and I'm really excited to get to this, but clearly not this month, because Lady Macbeth got 46%, which means Long Shadow by Olivia Atwater, with 54% is going to be added to the TBR, which I'm not surprised by, because I got a lot of messages saying, if this is the last book in the original Fairy Tale series, I need to know your opinion. Okay, I think I did really good with these ones, and they're both romances, and I think it's clear from the emojis and the colors what these are. On the left, we have like a minty green, a hockey net, a hockey puck and stick, a heart, and a handshake. Do you know what I'm talking about? This is for The Deal by Elle Kennedy. Don't ask me how I haven't read the series. I understand it's a rite of passage, okay? I wanna read the whole series together in succession. However, I have not done that, having owned them for multiple months now. If this gets added to the TBR, it'll force me to at least read the first one. I feel like they're a rite of passage, and I did the little handshake because it's like they're making a deal. Come on, it's good. And then on the right, we have a dark, dark navy blue, a plane, and a nut, obviously. We're talking about Mile High by Liz Tom Ford, which is a sports romance. And apparently this is the worst one, and I promise I will tough it out if I don't like it, because that's what everyone says to do, okay? But it won't be this month, because Mile High got 41%, and The Deal got 59%, meaning that's what's being added to the TBR. There's a receipt in here. I'm so bad at keeping track of receipts. Two fantasies that I would really love to read, would really love to get to. On the left, we have a purple cover, a purple flower, a heart, and a skull. I think this one was kind of obvious, which I'm proud of, okay? I'm so bad at attributing emojis to books. I'm proud that this one was obvious, which is Belladonna by Adeline Grace. I don't know how I haven't read the series, however, I did order the entire box set. It's sitting right up there. Heard so many amazing things about it, and I think it's going to be very good. I think it's gonna be very up my alley. What I know about this is that it's about a girl has been tossed around by family. See, I don't know a lot. I'm racking my brain, okay. If I remember correctly, she's been tossed around by families a lot, and the family that she's with now is kind of like her last chance. A woman from that family comes to her as a ghost and is like, you're in grave trouble, like we need to figure something out. And it turns out that death, the incorporeal being of death, might be her best bet. I'm not confident, okay? I'm not confident that's what it's actually about, but I think that's what it's about. And then on the right, we have a navy red. I did it again. What is navy red? A dark red, an auburn, dare I say, a sword, a vampire, and a crown. See, I think this one was good too, which is for Slaying the Vampire Conqueror by Carissa Broadbent. I got the lucky pleasure of reading an advanced copy of The Songbird and the Heart of Stone last month. Yeah, I know every single time I'm gonna love what she reads. She spins words in a way that makes me so grateful to be alive at the same time as these kinds of books. Now, to be fair, this isn't actually in the Crowns of Nyxia series, but it takes place in the Crowns of Nyxia world. And her little novella in between Serpent in the Wings of the Night and the Ashes and the Starker's King, Six Scorched Roses, that was a mouthful. That was literally a mouthful. It is a six-star novella, and I just want to read more in this world. This got 46%, and Belladonna got 54%, so pretty tight. This is going over here. Last, but certainly not least, on the left, we have a black cover, a nine, a house, a snake. What do you think it is? Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo, the polarizing book that I've been wanting to get to. People either love, love, love it, obsess with it, or really adamantly dislike it. And I want to be the person that likes it. So I haven't read it yet because I'm scared that I won't. And if I don't read it, then I can live in the fantasy that I for sure will, you know? However, I've been telling myself and you for a very long time that I'm going to read it in the fall. Fall's here, babe. So, and then on the left, another dark red, a pencil, a one, and a knife, which was for One of Us is Lying by Karen Ann McManus. Ever since finishing The Natural and A Good Girl's Guide to Murder, I have forever been trying to fill the hole that the true crime-esque YA genre left in me, and this will be the newest attempt. It will be, but not right now, because this got 43%, and Ninth House, these are all gonna fall. Ninth House got 57%, which I get it. I know you guys knew what that was, and I know I've been saying I'm gonna read it. And on that note, we officially have our 8-book October TBR. Ambitious, 100%. I want to read all of these, and if even a morsel of my brain feels a little bit less stressed because I don't have to pick and you picked for me and this is what I'm gonna read, I will take it. Feels like such a win. Thank you for picking my TBR. Thank you for playing with me. Also, let me know which of these you read and what ones you guys think I should get to as soon as possible, because I will do that. I think I need to start Immortal Dark soon, but I want to read all of these. Looking at them all, I want to read all of them. Can you tell that I'm just like a teeny tiny little bit excited for Fantasy Girl Fall? This feels like an ideal lineup. Manifesting that I show up for my wrap up in 30 days his time, and this is what the wrap up looks like. And on that note, with these all to be read, I should probably get to reading, and I hope to see you in the next one. Love you. Bye. Everybody, place your bets now. Do you think it's realistic that I'm gonna actually read all these, or do you think I'm gonna get distracted and mood read other things? Place your bets. Just place your bets.